Astrid Lindgren, Astrid Anna Emilia Lindgren, née Ericsson, November 14, 1907, January 28, 2002, was a Swedish writer of fiction and screenplays. She is best known for several children's book series, featuring Pippi Longstocking, Emil I Lönneberga, Karlsson-on-the-Roof, and the Six Bullerby Children, Children of Noisy Village in the U.S., and for the children's fantasy novels Mio, My Son, Ronia the Robber's Daughter, and the Brothers Lionheart. Lindgren worked children's literature editorial board at the Rabén and Sjögren Publishing House in Stockholm and has written more than 30 books for children. In January 2017, she was calculated to be the world's 18th most translated author, and the fourth most translated children's writer after Enid Blyton, H.C. Andersen and the Brothers Grimm. Lindgren has so far sold roughly 165 million books worldwide. Astrid Lindgren grew up in Nås, near Vimmerby, Småland, Sweden, and many of her books are based on her family and childhood memories and landscapes. Lindgren was the daughter of Samuel August Ericsson, 1875-1969, and Hanna Jonsson, 1879-1961. She had two sisters, aunt, and a brother, who eventually became a member of the Swedish Parliament. Upon finishing school, Lindgren took a job with a local newspaper in Vimmerby. She had a relationship with the chief editor, who was married and a father, and who eventually proposed marriage in 1926 after she became pregnant. She declined and moved to the capital city of Stockholm, learning to become a typist and stenographer. She would later write most of her drafts in stenography. In due time, she gave birth to her son, Lars, in Copenhagen and left him in the care of a foster family. Although poorly paid, she saved whatever she could and traveled as often as possible to Copenhagen to be with Lars, often just over a weekend, spending most of her time on the train back and forth. Eventually, she managed to bring Lars home, leaving him in the care of her parents until she could afford to raise him in Stockholm. In 1932 she married her employer, Sture Lindgren, 1898-1952, who left his wife for her. 3 years later, in 1934, Lindgren gave birth to her second child, Karen, who would become a translator. The character Pippi Longstocking was invented for her daughter to amuse her while she was ill in bed. Lindgren later related that Karen had suddenly said to her, "Tell me a story about Pippi Longstocking," and the tale was created in response to that request. The family moved in 1941 to an apartment on, with a view over Vasaparken, where Lindgren remained until her death on January 28, 2002 at the age of 94, having become blind. Astrid Lindgren died in her home in central Stockholm. Her funeral took place in the Storkyrkan, Great Church, in Gamla Stan. Among those attending were King Carl XVI Gustaf with Queen Silvia and others of the royal family, and Prime Minister Göran Persson. The ceremony was described as the closest you can get to a state funeral. Lindgren worked as a journalist and secretary before becoming a full-time author. She served as a secretary for the 1933 Swedish Summer Grand Prix. In 1944 Lindgren won second prize in a competition held by Rabén and Sjögren, a new publishing house, with the novel Britt Marie Lader Sitt Hjärta, Britt Marie Unburdens Her Heart. A year later she won first prize in the same competition with the chapter book Pippi Longstrump, Pippi Longstocking, which had been rejected by Bonniers. Rabén and Sjögren published it with illustrations by Ingrid van Nyman, the latter's debut in Sweden. Since then it has become one of the most beloved children's books in the world and has been translated into 60 languages. While Lindgren almost immediately became a much appreciated writer, the irreverent attitude towards adult authority that is a distinguishing characteristic of many of her characters has occasionally drawn the ire of some conservatives. The women's magazine Damerne Svarald sent Lindgren to the United States in 1948 to write short essays. Upon arrival she is said to have been upset by the discrimination against black Americans. A few years later she published the book Katie in America, a collection of short essays inspired by the trip. In 1956, the inaugural year of the Deutsche Jugendliteraturpreis, the German language edition of Mio, Min Mio, Mio, My Son, won the Children's Book Award. 16 books written by Astrid Lindgren made the Children's Book and Picture Book longlist, 1956-1975, but only Mio, My Son won a prize in its category. In 1958 Lindgren received the second Hans Christian Andersen Medal for Rasmus Paul Lufvin, Rasmus and the Vagabond, a 1956 novel developed from her screenplay and filmed in 1955. The Biennial International Board on Books for Young People, now considered the highest lifetime recognition available to creators of children's books, soon came to be called the Little Nobel Prize. Prior to 1962, the board cited a single book published during the preceding 2 years. On her 90th birthday, she was pronounced International Swede of the Year 1997 by Swedes in the World, SVIV, an association for Swedes living abroad. In its entry on Scandinavian fantasy, the Encyclopedia of Fantasy named Lindgren the foremost Swedish contributor to modern children's fantasy. Its entry on Lindgren summed up her work in glowing terms: her niche in children's fantasy remains both secure and exalted. Her stories and images can never be forgotten. By 2012, Astrid Lindgren's books had been translated into 95 different languages and language variants. Further, the first chapter of Ronia the Robber's Daughter has been translated into Latin. Up until 1997, a total of 3,000 editions of her books had been issued internationally, and globally her books had sold a total of 150 million copies. Many of her books have been translated into English by the translator Joan Tate. In 1976, a scandal arose in Sweden when it was publicized that Lindgren's marginal tax rate had risen to 102%. This was to be known as the Pomperipossa effect, from a story she published in Expressen on March 3, 1976, entitled Pomperipossa in Mona's Mania, attacking the government and its taxation policies. It was a satirical allegory in response to the marginal tax rate Lindgren had incurred in 1976, which required self-employed individuals to pay both regular income tax and employers' deductions. In a stormy tax debate, she attracted criticism from social democrats and even from her own colleagues, and responded by raising the issue of the lack of women involved in the social democrats' campaign. In that year's general election, the Social Democratic government was voted out for the first time in 44 years, and the Lindgren tax debate was one of several controversies that may have contributed to the result. Another controversy involved Ingmar Bergman's farewell letter to Sweden, after charges had been made against him of tax evasion. Lindgren nevertheless remained a Social Democrat for the rest of her life. Lindgren was well known both for her support for children's and animal rights and for her opposition to corporal punishment in the EU. In 1994, she received the Right Livelihood Award for her commitment to justice, nonviolence, and understanding of minorities, as well as her love and caring for nature. In 1967, the publisher Rabén and Sjögren established an annual literary prize, the Astrid Lindgren Prize, to mark her 60th birthday. The prize, 40,000 Swedish kronor, is awarded to a Swedish language children's writer every year on Lindgren's birthday in November. Following Lindgren's death, the government of Sweden instituted the Astrid Lindgren Memorial Award in her memory. The award is the world's largest monetary award for children's and youth literature, in the amount of 5 million Swedish kronor. The collection of Astrid Lindgren's original manuscripts in Kungliga Biblioteket in Stockholm, the Royal Library, was placed on UNESCO's Memory of the World Register in 2005. On April 6, 2011, Sweden's central bank's various Riksbank announced that Lindgren's portrait will feature on the 20 kroner banknote, beginning in 2014-15. In the run-up to the announcement of the persons who would feature on the new banknotes, Lindgren's name had been the one most often put forward in the public debate. Asteroid 3204 Lindgren, discovered in 1978 by Soviet astronomer Nikolai Cherenik, was named after her. The name of the Swedish microsatellite Astrid 1, launched on January 24, 1995, was originally selected only as a common Swedish female name, but within a short time it was decided to name the instruments after characters in Astrid Lindgren's books: Pippi, Prelude in Planetary Particle Imaging, Emil, Electron Measurements, In Situ and Lightweight, and Mio, Miniature Imaging Optics. In memory of Astrid Lindgren, a memorial sculpture was created next to her childhood home, named Kalla Astrid, Astrid's Wellspring in English. It is situated at the spot where Astrid Lindgren first heard fairy tales. The sculpture consists of an artistic representation of a young person's head, 1.37 meters high, flattened on top, in the corner of a square pond, and, just above the water, a ring of rosehip thorn, with a single rosehip bud attached to it. The sculpture was initially slightly different in design and intended to be part of a fountain set in the city center, but the people of Vimmerby vehemently opposed the idea. Furthermore, Astrid Lindgren had stated that she never wanted to be represented as a statue. However, there is a statue of Lindgren in the city center. The memorial was sponsored by the Culture Council of Vimmerby. Lindgren's childhood home is near the statue and open to the public. Just from Astrid's wellspring is a museum in her memory. The author is buried in Vimmerby, where the Astrid Lindgren's World Theme Park is also located. The Children's Museum Junibacken, in Stockholm, was opened in June 1996 with the main theme of the permanent exhibition being devoted to Astrid Lindgren. At the heart of the museum is a theme train ready through the world of Astrid Lindgren's novels. This is a chronological list of feature films based on stories by Astrid Lindgren. There are live-action films as well as animated features. The most films were made in Sweden, followed by Russia. Some are international co-productions. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.